Good morning, students. Coming to the next chapter, we will be studying about respiratory system in human. As you all know that energy is needed for all living beings to perform various vital activities. This energy is obtained from the oxidation of food material. So, for the oxidation of food material, an important process occurs in our body, that is respiration. Respiration is a catabolic process or a biochemical activity in which energy, water, and carbon dioxide are obtained due to oxidation of food which is present in the living cell. This energy is stored in the form of ATP. ATP is the energy currency of the cell. In this chapter, we will be studying about its type and the respiratory organs which help in respiration. We will also study about mechanism, that how does respiration occur, that is exchange of gases from the environment to our body cell and then to blood. We will also study certain volumes which are related to respiration. In emergency case, that is when accidentally drawn carbon monoxide or other gases toxicity or due to electric shock or in other circumstances, when our breathing stops but our heart remains continued working, then human life can be saved by giving artificial respiration. So we will also study about that mechanism. In the last, we will also discuss about certain disorder which are related to respiration. Children, now moving towards our chapter, respiration in human beings. First of all, we will see what is respiration. Respiration is a catabolic process in which the respired oxygen is used for oxidation of food with the release of energy. Catabolic process. Catabolic process means there are two type of reaction occurring in the body. First is anabolic and the second one is catabolic. All the reactions which are dealing with the synthesis of some material are known as anabolic reaction. And those reactions which include breakdown of any material are known as catabolic, and together they constitute metabolic reaction. So in case of respiration, breaking down, that is catabolic process, occur with the help of oxygen which we intake, and this oxygen is used for oxidation of food material which we are getting from digestive system, and this results in the formation of energy. This complete process occurs in respiration. Respiration is of two types, external and internal. External respiration is a physical process. Physical process means no chemical reaction occur in this. It just simply involves the exchange of gases between the animal and environment. In other words, we can also say that it is breathing. It involves taking in of oxygen and elimination of carbon dioxide. As you all know that in respiration, that is first part breathing, we just intake oxygen and eliminate carbon dioxide. No chemical reaction occur in this. So it is external respiration. Second is internal respiration. Internal respiration is also known as cellular respiration. Actually, it is a chemical process. Chemical process which involves breakdown of organic molecule along with release of energy in the form of ATP. ATP is the energy currency. In this, the exchange occurs between the blood capillaries and the tissue cells. The two type of respiration are external and internal, which are also known as breathing or ventilation and cellular respiration. Now, this cellular respiration, if it occurs in the presence of oxygen is termed as aerobic respiration, and if it occurs without the presence of oxygen, then it is known as anaerobic respiration. Thus, cellular respiration is broadly classified in aerobic and anaerobic respiration. The whole respiratory system is developed from the endoderm layer. In human being, the main respiratory organ is lungs. The other organs which support the lungs for respiration forms the air passage. The respiratory passage or respiratory organs are nostrils, opening in nasal chamber, then to nasopharynx, which opens in trachea through larynx and glottis, which finally leads to bronchi, and bronchi opens in lungs.